Our next elementary potential flow element is called a line vortex. And so we'll just draw that here along the z-axis. And we have x and y. We're actually going to use cylindrical coordinates. So that would mean that this is r and theta. And what the line vortex looks like is it's actually a flow that moves in the theta direction around the center of this vortex that lies on the z-axis here. And as you move out, the flow slows down. So as you get closer to that vortex, it speeds up, and as you move out, it slows down. And this flow actually satisfies Laplace's equation in all points in the space except for along the axis again. So there will be a singularity again along that axis. So let's write out what the velocity potential is for this flow in cylindrical coordinates. It's phi of r theta is equal to negative gamma over 2 pi theta. And if we take the derivative of that, so the velocity is simply del phi. If we do that in cylindrical coordinates, we get zero velocity in the r direction minus gamma over 2 pi r in the theta direction, and zero in the z direction. Okay, so that's a gamma there. Now, something interesting about this, if we were to choose a point in space here, or a closed surface in space, and integrate around that, we would find that that the circulation in that region is zero. But if we choose a region that actually encloses the line vortex here, then we'd find that the circulation is non-zero, and in fact it has a value of gamma, independent of the path around that vortex. And so that's the gamma that we actually use here in the equation, is the circulation strength of this line vortex. So again, we have a singularity at r equals zero. And you can see that the velocity in the theta direction drops off as 1 over r. We have a 1 over r relationship there. And then the sine of gamma simply determines the direction of rotation of the flow, whether it's clockwise or counterclockwise around that vortex line.